Hi, in this video we're going to see how to use the random number generator in C++. This is what's called a pseudo-random number generator. It doesn't generate a true random number, but it uses a function that varies such that the number that's the following after it makes a prediction basically doesn't appear to have any relationship to the previous number. However, when you start the random number generator, wherever you start it, it will always generate the same pseudo-random set of numbers. So we need to start the random number generator at a different place each time. So let's take a look at this program and see how it starts the random number generator at a different time. That's called seeding. And then we'll take a look and see how it's getting the random numbers out and what we can do with them. So the first part of the random number generator doesn't generate numbers at all. Instead, it uses this modulus. So let's take a look at this and see what this is doing. So we're going to enter two numbers. Both of them are going to be integers, and it's going to take the modulus of the two numbers. So it's that percent sign operator in C++. So let's try 6 modulus 6. So 6 modulus 6 is 0. So this means that when you divide 6 by 6, the remainder is exactly 0. Let's do 7, 6. So 7 modulus 6 is 1. Let's do 8 and 6. We get 2, 9 and 6, 3, 10 and 6, 4, 11 and 6, 5. And then look what happens when we do 12 and 6. It brings us back to 0. So we're going to use this modulus. This random number generator generates a very large integer value between certain limits, and we're going to use the modulus to take that number and transfer it into a number that varies between two limits. So if we do modulus 6, that's going to give us a value between 6 and 5. So if we're going to do a dice roll, all we need to do is just do modulus 6 and add 1. That's going to give us a number between 1 and 6 based on that random, pseudo-random integer that it creates. So this one's looking for a sentinel of 999, so let's enter that so we get out. And then it goes and it prints out the max rand. And you may want to also print out max rand when you're doing your program. It'll vary a little bit depending on the IDE and the system that you're using. But in this case, it's the 32767. How many times do you want to roll the dice? So let's roll it 100,000 times. And so we have a function in here that's calculating the dice roll. And so you can see that it's a fairly balanced roll. It's giving you about the same numbers as of 1s as 2s and 3s and 4s and 5s and 6s. There's nothing that's not captured in 1s through 6s. So let's see how this dice roll thing worked. So I'm going to go ahead and close the output, and then we'll go back to the program. So this is this first part that we were looking at, the modulus. So that part's not all that interesting. So let's go down here. So we're creating the seed the random number generator. Let's see what this function's doing. So this is where it gets a little bit weird, but just bear with me. I think this will make sense. So in order to seed the random number generator, we have to use this function srand. So s stands for seed, rand is our random number generator. And this comes from this include file, cstdlib. So it's the C standard library include file. But when we seed it, we have to seed it with a number. So the different approaches to this is you could have the user type in a number. But if they type in the same number each time, then it's going to give you the same sequence of random numbers. So one approach, and this is what we've done here, and this is what I would like for y'all to do in your dice program, is go ahead and seed it with the system time. So C++ has this Unix system time, which is the number of seconds from midnight January 1st, 1970. It was just a date that was selected. But in order to do this, we'll have to add another include file. So we have to do this include C time, and then you do your std colon colon srand open parentheses, and then std colon colon time, and then in the parentheses, this has to be in all caps, N-U-L-L. This is the null pointer. You just have to send time a pointer in order for it to return the system time. And then as soon as you do that, that determines where your starting point is in the random number sequence. And then from there, you can calculate random numbers. So let's look and see what else this program's doing. So I'm going to scroll back to main. So we want to print out rand max. So the way we do that is here, it's just this variable, rand underscore max. Rand underscore max is already defined in the C standard library. So once you include that file, then it's part of your program. It looks like that this should definitely have an int rand max, but don't include that statement because it's already defined in that include file. So this is a variable it's already set up for you. Now let's go back down to main and see what else it's doing. So it's just checking how many times we want to roll the dice. It's using a for loop since we know how many times we want to go through. A for loop's usually the easiest way to do that. And then here's our statement to roll the dice. So roll the dice is equal to random underscore number. We're going to pass it a 6, where 6 is the side of the dice. And then we just always need to add 1 to it. So let's look at and see what's in this rand underscore number. That function's up here. And rand underscore number takes the number of sides. And then it just uses this function, std colon colon rand, open close parentheses. It has to have the open close parentheses since it's a function. There's that percent sign, which is the modulus operator. And then we're just going to do modulus number of sides of dice. So that's about it. And then you've got a function that can return the dice roll. So thanks for watching.